Finally back again. I know, took another 2-month-ish break. I just take breaks left and right. I promise to try to be consistent this time. I always have struggled with consistently and uploading stuff, but I decided, you know what? Princess Leia came out. I told you guys I was going to switch it to a Leia farm, and then I was like, let me just restart, get the hyperdrive bundle. So much new shit has come out. And I wanted to have more fun. I'm going to be honest. I spent the $50. It's not really considered fully free to play. I did post something on like Reddit, like a poll. Do you guys want just to buy a hyperdrive bundle or just have it fully free to play? People were just like, nobody gives a fuck if you're fully free to play. So it's like, there's no bragging rights. It's not like, oh my gosh, I'm so much better than you because I'm fully free to play. Nobody cares, especially after these Lightspeed bundles. I even posted this before the Lightspeed bundles. So even before the Lightspeed bundles, people were like, we don't care if you're free-to-play. And now free-to-play is basically just dead because of the Lightspeed bundles. I do have a main account, actually free-to-play. But now that I actually bought the Hyperdrive bundle, I can't really consider this account free-to-play. But from now on, I'm not going to be buying anything else. I just want to let you guys know that. But we're back again, restarting again with the new end goal in Princess Leia or GL Leia, whatever. Now, it's going to take a while because she's got 4 more keys. But I assumed with the Hyperdrive bundle out, there's a chance that the new early game meta might switch from Imperial Troopers to just Phoenix. Now, Phoenix had been the go-to team before. I'm talking year back, go-to team was Phoenix. Rex came out. Phoenix are super good now. They are insanely fucking good. With Rex, they're so good. And I imagine, with Hyperdrive Bundle, maybe I can possibly I get all the Phoenix from the Hyperdrive Bundle. You get all their nodes unlocked, just every node in all the light and dark side, I'm pretty sure. You get Emperor Palpatine day one, which is huge. You get Grand Admiral Thrawn, but I didn't unlock him day one. I'm gonna be honest, I did not have the time to unlock him. But it's still, you basically unlock so much new people. You basically save the 3-month tutorial of level 1 to level 85 is with a regular free-to-play account, just for $50. So I was like, all right, let me send it and buy the Hyperdrive bundle. But pretty much what I was able to do on day 1, which is absolutely huge for the account, is I was able to unlock Commander Rex. Now, Commander Rex transforms the Phoenix. Like, on some things where I can't use Commander Rex because of his star, like, there's a star requirement for some things, like the mod battles, the mod challenges, whatever, where you need to have over 5 star for like the last tier and you can't use Rex with the Phoenix are awful. It's like, it's impossible to do that because my team just aren't good enough. Also, I didn't realize the Hyperdrive bundle does not buy you the things of like all the ships done. Like, you know, in Cantina battles, it's like 3 starred and everything. It doesn't give you that for ships, which really sucks because I just don't want to have to grind the light side, the ship stuff. But now I'm going to have to do it, but I'll do it off camera. I probably won't show you. It's so boring to watch. Oh, look, his overpowered ships beat the level 1 stuff. Oh, yeah, nobody fucking cares. But Scout Trooper is farmable, the Scout Trooper that you need to unlock Princess Leia is farmable from 5 beyond ships. So that's important. But basically, the trend of this account is Phoenix, Inter Emperor Palpatine, Grand Admiral Thrawn, as you saw from the intro, to get R2 and CLS. From R2 and CLS, you finish the squad out with Chewie and C-3PO. C-3PO usually is one of the hardest events in the game, but because Leia requires a bunch of Ewoks as her requirements, she requires, I'm pretty sure, Wicket, Chirpa, and Princess Kanisa. Kanisa has to be R7, so hopefully she makes the thing just easier just by herself. I never really tried the C-3PO event with just Kanisa, but hopefully she can turn it around. Another requirement is Drogon, who's great with rebel fighters, but like, I don't know if you guys know this already. He is absolutely insane with Leia. Just one popping. GL left and right. He is nuts with Leia. So, so good. But he's good before that. He's really good in Rebel Fighters. He's really good in the Sana team, which I'm going to invest in because one of her requirements is Cholo, Rolo. I think she needs Stormtrooper Han. I don't know for sure, but if she does, that slots in that Sana team. And then you add Drogon, you got a pretty good five right there until you get Leia. And pretty much, just with any Galactic Legend, it's just utilizing the requirements in the most efficient way possible, especially if you're free-to-play. I mean, I can't really consider this free-to-play, but I'm going to kind of basically call it free-to-play. Especially if you're free-to-play, you just got to utilize the requirements of a Galactic Legend to the best of their ability. Now, Scout Trooper is good in an Imperial Remnant squad. Like, that is so not good, because basically, I'm not going to be using Scout Trooper. I'm not going to be building up the Moff Gideon Imperial Troopers just to use Scout Trooper. So it comes to a point where it's, do you upgrade this marquee character who's going to take a while to grind to Relic 7 and just not use him? Like, what are you supposed to do with Scout Trooper, kind of? That's something I'm hoping is going to solve itself as the account begins to progress even further. Like, Drogon, marquee character, has a home. Kanisa, marquee character, she's not great with Ewoks, but she still has a home. Rex is Rex. We all know that he's really fucking good. And then all the other requirements, even Lando. I think Lando's one of the requirements. He has a home. Akbar is a requirement. He has a home. It's just Scout Trooper doesn't. And it comes to the point where I'm not going to build up this Imperial Remnant squad, which is not great. It's just solid just to use Scout Trooper. So I think it's going to come to a point where Scout Trooper is just going to slot into an Empire lineup and just hope it works. I don't know. I'm going to have to figure that out as the account continues to progress. But on day one, I was able to unlock the Hyperdrive Bundle, which is just huge for any account, really, in general. And speaking of the Hyperdrive account, I was planning on doing a giveaway. So if you did watch till about 7 minutes into the video, most people don't. But if you did make it here and you subscribe, you'll be entered into just a collection of people. So I'll basically pull a name out of a random hat out of people that are subscribed to me. I have basically 50 subs, so you have a very high, you have 2% chance of getting chosen, and you get a Hyperdrive Bundle. Or I'll just Venmo, PayPal, whatever, blah, 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 give you $50. You can spend that however you want. If you want to buy, I don't know, if you have kids and you want to buy them a toy, you can do that. If you want to spend money on a stupid mobile game, yeah, you can do that too. But do whatever you want. It's your money. Hopefully, whoever wins, good luck to you, and thanks for watching this long if you do hear this right now. Because I'm going to be honest, my viewer retention is not the best, but it is what it is. Might as well mention that giveaway before I forget about it. So, as I was saying, on day number one, I did the Galactic Challenge, which I was able to do. And thankfully, it was a Phoenix. It was for Phoenix characters. So that was like, that's pretty light. That's easy. Then we also, on the first day of this account, was able to unlock Emperor Palpatine. Now, Palpatine is huge for any account, especially in the early game. He's great with Mara Jade. I don't really know if I'm going to farm her yet, but eventually, one way or another, Mara Jade will be farmed at one point because she's just so good. Even at 2-star, she's amazing. You don't even need a Zeta on her. She's that good. It's just the way she works with spamming debuffs constantly. She really lifts up that Emperor Palpatine team with Vader as well and Grand Admiral Thrawn. You're going to be able to unlock pretty easily with this Phoenix squad. Especially now, the Phoenix is actually pretty good. You're not going to need the highest gear levels out there to be able to unlock Thrawn. So, Mara Jade really wraps up, puts like a kind of little, puts a, and I'm blanking on the word right now, a ribbon on the present of the Empire team. If you get what I'm saying. That was, analogy took way too long. This is just bleh. The analogy took too long. Whatever. It is what it is. But basically, Mara Jade's really good. You also have Rebel Fighters, which is where you can use Drogon, besides a Sana team. Drogon just works in every single Rebel team. He's great. Drogon's great. Just the requirements for Leia all around are great. But another thing that you always have to think of whenever you're making an account in Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes is the ships. What are you going to do for ships? Now, the Hyperdrive Bundle gives you a couple of ships to choose from. It gives you a lot to choose from. You get your Phoenix ships. You even get like Vulture's Roy, which takes months upon months to farm regularly. And you just get that for free to 5-stars, which is huge because ships are a grind and ships fucking suck. So getting these ships up and running really puts you ahead of the ball game compared to the other people, where you can just do Fleet Arena, climb Fleet Arena, and then start to get those juicy crystals. Now, Fleet Arena is important. It's huge. You get free crystals. It's huge in Grand Arena. If you have one of the quote-unquote Galactic Legend fleets, that's Executor, Profundity, Leviathan. If you have one of those three, nobody's beating you because you just place that in the back wall. Nobody can beat that. So the thing is, if you're farming Leia, who's your ship? You can't really get the Executor because that's kind of out of the way. Leviathan, just a no-go for any free-to-play account unless you want to spend 2 years grinding it. So the most logical thing is Profundity, but you need a Relic 9. So I'm kind of like bouncing between Profundity or Executor as I'm going for Leia. I don't really know yet. Please let me know in the comments. I just don't really know what to do for ships. I'm not a great ships guy. I'm not going to lie. Whenever I play Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes, I always just I hate ships. It's so boring in my opinion, but it's a very, very important and vital part to the game. So without further ado, that's the end of the video. Thank you guys for watching. Thanks for everything. I hope this new series comes out. I hope I have a consistent upload schedule. That's probably not going to happen, let's be honest. But I hope you guys enjoy. If you have any feedback, let me know in the comments down below. And see you later.